Hi guys, welcome to NFI online video tutorials. And in this series of video, I'm going to teach about how to work on encoders. Now encoders, if you are aware of encoder, these are used to take a feedback from a motor. Generally we use encoder to take a feedback from induction motor, or if you have any other device, any other rotating device or linear device from where you need a feedback, we can use an encoder. This is how an encoder looks like, right? This is a spindle on the top which you can move, which you can follow. It's free to move, alright? And there's a wire at the back which is going to my PLC, alright? So now, what is an encoder and what is inside it? So I'll show you one image which will explain you what is inside the encoder. Now if you see that, this is the shaft. That's the same shaft which you can see here. This is the shaft. Now inside that encoder, you'll find a disc. And in that disc, there are some slots, very precisely, you know, made slots inside. And you'll find three things: phase A, phase B, and phase Z. So phase A slits, these are slots of phase A, and this is a phase B, and this is Z phase. So at the one end, you have LEDs, light emitting diodes, which are emitting some lights, all right, continuously. And you have phototransistors on the other end. So what happens when this disc rotates? This light signal get passed across through the slit to the phototransistors and it gets some pulses. Alright, so the more the speed is, the more is the frequency of the pulses. That's how we read that pulses, and this pulses get, you know, you can find this pulses coming out from your wires of encoders. So you need some controlling device, some controllers to read that pulses. Then you can find out what is actually happening to the motor. You can find out three things using this encoder by reading the pulses, and these are position, RPM, and direction. Three things, alright. Now to see the wiring, how encoder is wired, let's see an example. Now this is the encoder, a diagram which will indicate it's an encoder, and if you see, the voltage reading is 10 to 30 VDC. This is DC voltage. Now it has five wires, you can see here, this is a five connecting terminal box. Now 10 to 30 VDC means you can give the voltage in the range of 10 to 30 to this encoder. In this case, we are providing 24 and 0. This is the one input in which you have to provide high DC voltage. This is the second one for low DC voltage. And if you are giving 24 volts, the pulses you will get will be in this range. So that's it. You can also give 12 volts. It's totally up to you. So what I'm giving 24 volts, and from this A, B, and Z, I'm getting pulses of 0 volts, alright, low voltage pulses. You may find some encoders having three more wires, which is A bar, B bar, and Z bar, or A slash, B slash, or Z slash. In that, if this is giving you 0 volt, A slash will give you 24 volts, same pulses, but it's the inverse, alright, so that's the wiring. Now this 360 ppr, this is pulse per revolutions, that's the resolution of the encoder. Every encoder has some resolution. So this 360 means when I rotate this by 1 RPM, if you see here, if I rotate it by 1 revolution.rpm, it will give me 360 pulses, not 360 ppr. Now how these pulses will be coming, we have three things, A, B, and Z. Now what happened in A? This is the A phase. When you rotate the encoder in clockwise direction, this A pulses will start coming, alright, and B pulse will come after the A pulse. This is having a phase shift. So that's the nature of the pulses which will be coming from the encoder when you rotate clockwise. Now this, the number of pulses will be 360 per revolution. So it means when you rotate this encoder by 1 revolution, you'll get 360 pulses of A phase and 360 pulses of B phase. And the Z phase is this one here. I'll come to this one. So when you rotate anti-clockwise, the only difference is the B phase will come and then A phase will come. That's like that. So this will help us to find out what is the direction of your encoder. You can use that one. And now again, Z phase. Now Z phase is the only one which give you just one pulse per revolution. Alright, for every revolution it will give you one pulse, because if you see this figure, this is the Z slit and this is just one in the whole disc. It's just one. So it will give you one pulse per revolutions. So again, I have A phase which will give me 360 ppm because that's the resolution, and B phase will come after A phase if you rotate the encoder in clockwise direction. If you rotate anti-clockwise, then first B phase will come and then A phase will come. And how to wire this encoder now? So we'll do some we'll do three exercises in which we'll be wiring this encoder to inputs of PLC, alright? So that we'll do in the next video. This was about how to wire the encoder, what are the feedback we can get, and some basics about encoder. I hope this makes sense. I'll see you in the next video about connecting the encoder to the PLC and reading the feedback. Thank you.